tonight. Oh, down beside that red firelight. Oh, you're gonna let it all hang out. Fat bottom girls, you make the rockin' world go round.
Hi everybody, Bro here with VIP Outdoors. Today we're going to be going over how to properly set up your fishing rod while trolling for salmon here in the Northwest, okay? So to get started, there's going to be a few things you're going to need. You're going to need a couple of 6 to 8 millimeter beads, a barrel swivel that's connected to a piece of 20 pound monofilament about 18 inches long with a dual lock at the end of that. You are also going to need 3 6 bead swivels connected to large dual locks at the opposite end. In addition, you will need an 18 piece of 50 pound monofilament leader, a flasher. Now, flashers are optional. I like using them more in the system where we got a little bit bigger water, more color to the water. Okay, these are our custom VIP outdoor flashers. Multiple, they come in multiple different colors and actually a few different sizes. So check these out online. You're going to need a Mooching leader, Mooching rig, 5.5 foot long. I use 25 pound monofilament leader. Some people use 30, that's absolutely fine. It's a matter of personal preference. I change them after every fish, so I like 25. I have 2 3-aught needle, super needle point owner hooks on here. They're fixated on there at 3.5 inches apart from eye to eye. That just, it's a matter of the type of herring you're fishing. I fish green label herring, and that seems to be the perfect distance between the two. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your main line, okay? This is my main line. I like using braided on my main line for when trolling for salmon. Put your first bead on there. That first bead is just gonna protect your guides up there so nobody reels that swivel in all the way through your guides and busts them up. From there, you're gonna put your barrel swivel on there. Slide that barrel swivel on there. I happen to already have mine tied to that piece of mono and the dual lock that we had here. That's my dropper. That's what my weight's gonna be connected to. So it's tied on there. If you haven't done it yet, that's fine. Just tie it on there. 18 piece or 18 inch piece of 20 pound mono, directly do a dual lock at the end, okay? Then you're gonna take your other bead and sandwich that barrel swivel in there between the two beads. Just drop it on there just like that. Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna tie that directly to your first 6 bead swivel. Now this 6-bead swivel does not have any dual locks. I think I said at the beginning all of them have dual locks. One of them does not, okay? So go ahead and take it off one of them. So you're gonna tie that directly to that. Tighten it down nice and tight. Use a good knot or a few different ones. Okay, that's tied directly to that now. Now what I do from that 6-bead swivel to my next, I use an 18-inch piece of 50-pound monofilament. That 50-pound monofilament, a lot of people think that's pretty heavy. Well, it is. I want that to be nice and heavy. One of the main reasons is because this is going to do a lot of spinning in the water. I don't want this to get all looped and kinked up on me. That's the most important reason. The second reason, and pretty important reason, is flashers aren't cheap. I don't care who you buy them from, where you get them, they're not cheap. So I don't like losing flashers, especially if I have one that catches me fish. So what you're gonna do is from there, hook your second set of 6-bead swivels and your dual lock directly up to your flasher. Clip that on there. So as of right now, this is what you have right here, okay? You have a bead, a barrel swivel, a bead, six bead chain swivel, your little bit of a leader there, 50 pound mono, directly down to another six bead swivel, onto your flasher, all right? Now onto that flasher, your intake, your last six bead swivel with the dual lock and clip it onto the bottom there, just like that, all right? From there, all you do is take your Mooching rig, your leader, 5.5 foot leader, and tie it directly to the bottom of that. Okay. Now, something to keep in mind, not a lot of people put thought into this, but you know, the different types of monofilaments you use, all of them have a different weight to them. Okay, and it's pretty important, really. A lot of people like fluorocarbon because of the clarity. Keep in mind that fluorocarbon is heavier than other monofilaments, okay? So therefore, it's gonna have a tendency to sink. That's gonna play a big part in how fast you're fishing, number one, and how many cranks you're gonna get off the bottom, because generally speaking, we're fishing so many cranks off the bottom. A lot of people, you know, like one or two cranks. Well, I see a lot of guys do one crank, but they're fishing a 6 foot, you know, fluorocarbon leader, that's dragging on the bottom because that leader weighs so much more than a standard mono. So something to keep in mind, you know, play with that a little bit, okay? Then what you're gonna do is go back up here to your dropper. This is your dropper. This is what your weight's gonna be connected to. How much weight is depending on where you're fishing, how deep of water. Generally speaking, for spring Chinook, I fish anywhere from 4 to 8 ounces of a cannonball weight is what I hook onto there. So anyways, that's what we have, guys. That's how you set up a trolling rig with a Mooching leader for spring and fall Chinook. This is specifically for spring with this type of weight. But yeah, hopefully this helps you catch more fish. Take a look at us at VIPOutdoors.com and check us out on Facebook. Thanks for tuning in, guys.